In this video, we'll be discussing the Resuscitation Quality Improvement Program, or RQI, and why you and your organization should consider implementing the program. How many of you participate in a sport? Why do we practice 2 to 3 times a week when doing a sport, but as healthcare providers, we find it acceptable to practice our CPR skills once every 2 years during a CPR course? The old saying that practice makes perfect is no less true in resuscitation quality improvement than in any other human activity. The more often resuscitation knowledge and skills are used and practiced, the better the performance, which will lead to better patient outcomes. So what is the problem? There are more than 500,000 cardiac arrests annually in the United States. Out of hospital to neurological intact survival is at about 11.4%, whereas in-hospital survival rates is about 23.8%. This means only about a quarter of patients survive in-hospital cardiac arrest. This is such a significant number. We know that poor quality CPR is a preventable harm and that the 2-year retraining cycles are not optimal. More frequent training in BLS, ACLS, and PALS may be beneficial for providers who are likely to encounter a cardiac arrest. There is also substantial evidence to suggest that mastery learning is the key to skill retention and the prevention of rapid decay in skills and knowledge after simulation-based learning. The goal of mastery learning is to have learners achieve the highest standard for all education outcomes instead of simply meeting the minimum standard. So what does the old training strategy we all are familiar with look like? Students attend a BLS, an ACLS or PALS course every 2 years, and certification was issued based on demonstrated performance at that time. We know that skills degradation is steep. In as little as 3 to 6 months after a standard course, skill decay of up to 50% can be seen. And this is what we see. People complete training and they are at the top of the curve. And then as time progresses through the 2-year cycle, they end at the bottom of the graph. And this cycle continues as they renew their certifications. High quality CPR is the single greatest determinant for survival from cardiac arrest and is the foundation for which all other therapies should be built on. And that's from the 2013 AHA consensus statement. A study by Niles et al. Also concluded that healthcare providers often do not meet AHA guidelines on chest compression fraction, chest compression rates, and chest compression depth targets, and compliance is poor. So what is RQI? RQI is the innovative training program from RQI Partners, a collaboration between the American Heart Association and Laerdal Medical. RQI is a maintenance of competency solution. It helps hospitals and healthcare providers maintain their competency and achieve better patient outcomes through regular, low-dose, high-frequency training. RQI stations are strategically located throughout organizations and is available 24 hours a day, which helps to minimize loss of productivity, so professionals can access the stations anytime when they are ready. These skill sessions occur every quarter and usually takes less than 10 minutes. The system provides visual and audio feedback. Every quarter, there's a cognitive or online component that participants need to complete. And on successful completion, the provider's AHA e-card will be extended by 3 months. Another benefit of RQI is that providers are provided with the expedited AHA science updates. So what's included? Adult and child compressions. Adult and child ventilations. Infant compressions. And infant ventilations. As the student practices a skill, the system will provide coaching.
Great. Very good. Very good.
Here we see high quality chest compressions from the participant.
You're doing well.
At a rate of between 100 to 120 pushes
Great.
Per minute.
Good. Great. Very good. Great. Thank you. You can stop now.
Immediately, once a student has performed the skill at the station, it will provide an overview of the activity. You can click on the analyze result to get a deeper understanding of your performance. If you want to have more information about a skill, you can easily click on watch a tip icon. Here you will see a short video with tips on how to improve skills. RQI is an evolution in the quality of resuscitation training. By incorporating the components of mastery learning, participants have increased confidence, competence, and willingness to respond to cardiac arrest events. Conducting regular mock codes or skill drills with dynamic team training is an essential component for RQI program success and driving the culture of excellence. With compliance of the low dose, high frequency delivery of RQI content, the RQI provider will maintain and validate life-saving skills regularly to combat skills decay and work towards mastery of skills. And this is the type of mastery of competency graph that we want to see. Better delivery of high-quality CPR to our patients will save more lives. On successful completion of RQI activities, a virtual course completion card will be issued. This simplifies card management. It's eco-friendly and convenient. Providers have self-service access to card replacement, and they can print it if needed. Both a standard 2-year AHA card, if needed, for regulatory requirements gets issued, and the gold standard RQI verified card. With RQI One-Stop Management Platform, it provides us with automated RQI scheduling and assignments. The system has integrated notification to participants, and the administrators can customize these notifications. The administrators also have easy access to reporting of student participation, and RQI Analytics also provides us with excellent information about where your organization stands at any given time with the quality of CPR your team performs. RQI hits the trifecta. The program is innovative, creative, and ensures quality improvement, which leads to better patient outcomes, provides convenience as staff members can access the stations when they are ready, and it also helps organizations with cost savings. In summary, we know high quality CPR saves lives. We need to understand where changes can be made in our programs to increase survival rates. Organizations committed to high quality CPR training deliver high quality for every patient, every time, regardless of outcomes. Lastly, to close this RQI overview, I want to quote legendary American football coach Vince Lombardi. Practice does not make perfect. Only perfect practice makes perfect. I think this sums up the RQI perfectly. If you benefited from this video, kindly like, subscribe, and smash that notification bell. We'll place links in the description about RQI. We'll see you in the next video. Have a fantastic day.